Hi everyone, my name is Pauline. As a nuclear medicine resident, I see a lot of people with thyroid diseases. This is why I made a series of videos in which I explain everything related to the thyroid, from physiology to pathology to some important diagnostic tools. You can choose to watch them all, or you can go to the playlist and watch the videos that seem interesting to you. This is the third in a series of four teaching videos about the thyroid gland. In this video, we'll talk about hypothyroidism. More specifically, I will tell you everything about the different causes of hypothyroidism, the clinical features, the investigations, and how to manage those diseases. Hypothyroidism refers to any state in which the thyroid gland can't make enough thyroid hormone to keep the body running normally. There can be many reasons why the cells in the thyroid gland can't make enough thyroid hormone. Here are the major causes, from the most to the least common. In some people's bodies, the immune system that protects the body from invading infections can mistake the thyroid gland cells for invaders and can attack them. Then there aren't enough thyroid cells and enzymes left to make enough thyroid hormone. This is more common in women than men. Autoimmune thyroiditis can begin suddenly or it can develop slowly over years. The most common forms are Hashimoto thyroiditis and atrophic thyroiditis. Thyroiditis can make the thyroid dump its whole supply of stored thyroid hormone into the blood at once, causing brief hyperthyroidism followed by hypothyroidism. Some people with thyroid nodules, thyroid cancer, or Graves' disease need to have part or all of their thyroid removed. If the whole thyroid is removed, people will definitely become hypothyroid. If a part of the gland is left, it may be able to make enough thyroid hormone to keep blood levels normal. Some people are treated with radioactive iodine for the purpose of destroying their thyroid gland. Patients with Hodgkin's disease, lymphoma, or cancer of the head or neck can be treated with external radiation. All these patients can lose part or all of their thyroid function. Drugs such as amiodarone or lithium can prevent the thyroid gland from being able to make thyroid hormones normally. These drugs are most likely to trigger hypothyroidism in patients who have a genetic tendency to autoimmune thyroid disease. The thyroid gland must have iodine to make thyroid hormone. Iodine comes into the body in food and travels through the blood to the thyroid. Keeping thyroid hormone production in balance requires the right amount of iodine. Taking in too much iodine can cause or worsen hypothyroidism. The pituitary or the master gland tells the thyroid how much hormone to make. When a pituitary is damaged by a tumor, radiation, or surgery, it may no longer be able to give the thyroid the right instructions and the thyroid may stop making enough hormone. When thyroid hormone levels are too low, the cells in our body can't get enough thyroid hormone and the body's processes start slowing down. As the body slows, you may notice that you feel colder, you tire more easily, your skin is getting drier, you're becoming forgetful and depressed, and you've started getting constipated. Because these symptoms are so variable and nonspecific, the only way to know for sure whether your patient has hypothyroidism is with a simple blood test for T4 and TSH. TSH measures how much of the thyroid hormone the thyroid gland is being asked to make. An abnormally high TSH and low T4 means hypothyroidism. Hypothyroidism cannot be cured, but in almost every patient, hypothyroidism can be completely controlled. It is treated by replacing the amount of hormone that your own thyroid can no longer make to bring your T4 and TSH levels back to normal. So even if your thyroid gland can't work right, T4 replacement can restore your body's thyroid hormone levels and your body's function. Synthetic T4 pills contain hormone exactly like the T4 that the thyroid gland itself makes. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to see more of my videos where I explain various medical topics in an easy and understandable way, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button if you want to get notified every time I upload a video. You've learned in the last three videos how the thyroid gland works and what happens if the thyroid gland produces too much or too little thyroid hormone. In the next video, I will tell you everything you need to know about a thyroid scan and radioactive iodine.